Hello children, good evening all of you. Welcome to day 3 class of factorization and polynomials. Children, we recall once again, in yesterday's class we learnt about zero of the polynomial. What is zero of the polynomial? How to find zero of the polynomials? And the given values are whether zeros of the given polynomial are not. And division of polynomials and remainder theorem. Once we recall remainder theorem, children, what is remainder theorem? P of x is any polynomial of degree greater than or equal to 1. And x minus a is a linear polynomial. If P of x is divided by x minus a, then the remainder is P of a. This is the remainder theorem. In that remainder theorem, if remainder is 0, P of A is 0, then we said that x minus A is factor of P of X. Today, we will learn about factors of a polynomial, factorization and factor theorem. What is factor? In our numerals, what is factor? Do you remember, children? If 24 is divisible by 6, six four 24, so 24 is exactly divisible by 6, therefore 6 is the factor of 24. At the same time, quotient 4 is also factor of 24. It is also same applicable for our polynomials. If P of x is a polynomial and g of x is another polynomial. If P of x is exactly divisible by the another polynomial g of x, then g of x is said to be factor of the given polynomial P of x. And the quotient Q of x is also factor of P of x. Okay, children? Now, we will learn about factor theorem. What is factor theorem? Let P of x be any polynomial of degree greater than or equal to 1 and A is any real number. If P of A is equal to 0, then x minus A is factor of P of x. If P of A is equal to 0, P of A means it is remainder from remainder theorem. If P of A is equal to 0, then x minus A is factor of given polynomial P of X and its converse. What is converse of it? If x minus A is factor of P of X, then P of A is equal to 0. If x minus A is factor of P of X, then the remainder P of A is equal to 0. This is factor theorem. That means if remainder is 0, the divisor is factor of given polynomial. If divisor is factor of given polynomial, then the remainder is 0. If P of A is equal to 0, then X minus A is factor of P of X and its converse, if x minus a is factor of P of x, then P of a is equal to 0. We will see some problems on the application of this factor theorem. Okay, children? Now, check whether x minus 2 is a factor of x cube minus 4x square plus x plus 6. What we have to do? We have to check whether x minus 2 is a factor of this polynomial. That means, if it is a factor of this polynomial, then the remainder have to be 0. Okay, so what is remainder if we divide with x minus 2? From the remainder theorem, remainder is P of A. That means P of 2 is remainder here. Let the given polynomial be P of x. P of x is equal to x cube minus 4x square plus x plus 6. we have to find the value of p of 2. That means in the given polynomial, instead of variable, we have to write 2. X cube, 2 cube minus 4 into x square. Instead of x, 2 plus x, 2 plus 6. 2 cube means it is 8 minus 4 into 2 square. 2 square means 2, 2 ja 4 plus 2 plus 6. 8 minus 4, 4 ja 16 plus 2 plus 6. 8 plus 2, 10. 10 plus 6, 16 minus 16. 16 minus 16 is equal to 0. Here, p of 2 is equal to 0. From the factor theorem, first, what is the factor theorem? If p of a is equal to 0, then x minus a is factor of p of x. From this factor theorem, here p of 2 is equal to 0. Therefore, x minus 2 is factor of given polynomial p of x. X cube minus 4x square plus x plus 6. Okay, children? Now, we will see one more problem. Check whether 2x plus 3 is a factor of 4x cube plus 20x square plus 33x plus 18. It is also like same problem. But here x minus 2 means what is the remainder? P of 2. Here 2x plus 3. It is in the form of ax plus b. Then what will be the remainder here, children? Minus b by a. That means minus 3 by 2. So, let the given polynomial p of x is equal to 4x cube plus 20x square plus 33x plus 18. Now, what we have to find? P of minus 3 by 2. That means, in the given polynomial, instead of x, we have to write minus 3 by 2. So, 4 into x cube. In place of x, we have to write minus 3 by 2 plus 20 into x square minus 3 by 2 plus 33 into x. In place of x, minus 3 by 2 plus 18. Now, 4 into minus 3 by 2 whole cube. What is minus 3 by 2 whole cube? That means we have to write minus 3 by 2 how many times, children? Minus 3 by 2 into minus 3 by 2 into minus 3 by 2. Minus into minus plus, plus into minus minus. How to multiply these fractions? Numerator into numerator, divide denominator into denominator. 3 3s are 9, 9 3s are 27 by 2 2s are 4, 4 2s are 8. So 4 into minus 27 by 8 plus 20 into minus 3 by 2 square. So minus 3 by 2 into minus 3 by 2. Minus into minus plus. 3 3s are 9 by 2 2s are 4. So 20 into 9 by 4 plus 33 into minus 3 by 2. That means 33 into 3. It is minus 99 by 2 plus 18. 4 is in the numerator and 8 is in the denominator. So 4 1 ja, 4 2 ja. And here 4 is in the denominator and 20 in the numerator. 4 1 ja, 4 5 ja. So what are the terms remained, children? 1 into 27. 27. Here minus is there. Minus 27 by 2 plus 5 into 9. 5 9 ja 45. Here plus and here minus. Plus into minus. Minus 99 by 2 plus 18. You see children, minus 27 by 2, minus 99 by 2. These two fractions are, I am writing it together. Minus 27 by 2, minus 99 by 2. And this 45 plus 18, plus 45 and plus 18. What will be the answer children? Plus 45 and plus 18 is plus 63. Now, how to add these two fractions? This is minus and this is minus. Two fractions are minus, negative. So we have to add these two fractions. How to add? Denominator is equal. That means these two are like fractions. Therefore, numerators can be added directly. Plus 63. Minus 27, minus 99. How much children? It is minus 126 by 2 plus 63. 126 by 2 means 2 1 ja, 2 6 ja, 2 3 ja. Minus 63 plus 63. So the answer is 0. Since P of minus 3 by 2 is 0, therefore this 2x plus 3 is factor of given polynomial 4x square plus 24x cube plus 20x square plus 33x plus 18. Okay children, got it? Since the value of P of minus 3 by 2, since P of A is 0, X minus A is factor. Here minus 3 by 2 is 0. Therefore, what will be the linear polynomial here? 2X plus 3 is factor of given polynomial according to factor theorem. Okay children? Okay children, one more problem. Determine whether x minus 1 is a factor of x cube minus x square minus x plus 1 and second polynomial x cube minus x square minus 3 minus root 3 of x plus root 3. That means we have to check whether x minus 1 is a factor of these two polynomials. First one we will take. Let P of x is equal to x cube minus x square minus x plus 1. So we have to check x minus 1 is a factor. That means we have to find the value of P of 1. So in place of variable in a given polynomial, we have to write 1. 1 cube minus x square, so 1 square minus x minus 1 plus 1. 1 cube means you all know children it is 1. Minus 1 square means 1. Minus 1 plus 1. 1 minus 1, minus 1 plus 1, all are getting cancelled and the value of P of 1 is 0. Since P of 1 is 0, from the factor theorem, x minus 1 is factor of this polynomial, x cube minus x square minus x plus 1. Okay children, now we will check it for the second polynomial, x cube minus x square minus 3 minus root 3 x plus root 3. Let the given polynomial P of x, P of x is equal to x cube minus x square minus 3 minus root 3 x plus root 3. So here also we have to check x minus 1 is a factor or not. Therefore we have to find the value of P of 1. So in the given polynomial instead of x we have to write 1 plus root 3. So I wrote all the brackets instead of variables. So now in the brackets I am writing 1. X cube 1 cube. 1 cube means 1 minus 1 square 1 minus 3 minus root 3 into 1. So it is 3 minus root 3 plus root 3. 1 minus 1, it is 0, and minus is out of the bracket. If you open the brackets, minus into 3, minus 3, minus into minus, plus root 3, plus root 3. Is anything is cancelling here? No. So, minus 3 plus root 3 plus root 3 means it is root 3. So, shall we get 0 here? No. So, is x minus 1 is factor of this polynomial, children? No. Since p of 1 is not equal to 0, the x minus 1 is not the factor of given polynomial x cubed minus x square minus 3 minus root 3x plus root 3. Okay, children? Okay, children, one more problem. Determine whether x plus 1 is a factor of x cubed plus 3x square plus 3x plus 1. What is the given polynomial here? Let p of x is equal to x cubed plus 3x square plus 3x plus 1. What we have to check? Whether x plus 1 is a factor or not. If x plus 1 is a factor, what will be the remainder? P of minus 1. That means in the given polynomial, we have to write minus 1 instead of variable. X cubed plus 3x square plus 3x plus 1. So we have to find minus 1, minus 1, minus 1. Minus 1 cube. What is minus 1 cube, children? Minus 1 is writing 3 times. We will get minus 1. So minus 1 cube minus 1 plus 3 into minus 1 square means it is plus 1. Plus into minus. Minus 3 1 ja 3 plus 1. Minus 1 plus 3 1 ja 3 minus 3 plus 1. Minus 1 plus 1 plus 3 minus 3 getting cancelled and the answer is 0. Since p of minus 1 is equal to 0, x plus 1 is a factor of given polynomial x cubed plus 3x square plus 3x plus 1. Okay, children, once you observe, we can generalize here. X minus 1 is a factor of x cubed minus x square minus x plus 1. What are the sum of coefficients here, children? X cube coefficient is 1. X square coefficient is minus 1. X coefficient is minus 1. And the constant is nothing but x power 0. So x power 0 coefficient is 1. What is the sum of all these coefficients? 1 plus minus 1 plus minus 1 plus 1. 1 minus 1. Minus 1 plus 1. It is 0. That means if the sum of coefficients of variables in the given polynomial, then x minus 1 is factor of given polynomial. This condition applies always. Whenever it applicable, if sum of coefficients of variables in the given polynomial is equal to 0, then definitely x minus 1 is factor of that polynomial. Okay, children? Now coming to here, when the x plus 1 will be the factor, what are the coefficients of here? X cube coefficient is 1. X square coefficient is 3. X coefficient is 3. And here x power 0, 1 into x power 0, constant term is 1. You observe, children, here x cube coefficient plus x coefficient, 1 plus 3 is equal to 4. And x square coefficient and x power 0 coefficient, 3 plus 1 is equal to 4. That means sum of the coefficient of odd powers of variable. 3 and 1 are odd numbers. So odd powers of variables is equal to sum of the coefficients of even powers. In any polynomial, if the sum of odd powers of coefficients is equal to sum of even powers of coefficients, then definitely x plus 1 is factor of that given polynomial. Without making the division or without finding this value, we can directly, by observing the coefficients of given polynomial, we can say whether x minus 1 is a factor or x plus 1 is a factor. Okay, children, we will see some more problem. Okay, children, one more problem. If x square minus 1 is a factor of ax power 4 plus bx cube plus cx square plus dx plus e, then show that a plus c plus e is equal to b plus d is equal to 0. What are these a, c, e, b, d, children? You observe the given polynomial ax power 4 plus bx cube plus cx square plus dx plus e. This a, b, c, d, e are coefficients of variables in the given polynomial. What is the factor here? X square minus 1 is the factor. So, let us write. The given polynomial p of x is equal to ax power 4 plus bx cube plus cx square plus dx plus e. Now, what is the factor here? X square minus 1 is the factor of p of x. You observe, children, x square minus 1, it can be written as x square minus 1 square. You can recall one algebraic identity here, children, a square minus b square. What is the formula of a square minus b square? It is a plus b into a minus b. That means x square minus 1 square can be written as x plus 1 into x minus 1. So, x square minus 1 is the factor. And x square minus 1 can be written as x plus 1 into x minus 1. You observe your example, children. 16 is equal to 2 into 8. So, 2 is the factor of 16 and also 8 is also factor of 16. Like that, x square minus 1 is equal to x plus 1 into x minus 1. Therefore, x plus 1 is factor of x square minus 1. And x minus 1 is also factor of x square minus 1. So, since x square minus 1 is a factor, here x plus 1 is factor of given polynomial p of x. And so, children, x plus 1 is a factor of p of x. And x minus 1 is also factor of p of x. We observe, children, in the previous problem, what we generalized, if sum of the coefficients of variables are a plus b plus c plus d plus e in the given polynomial, sum of coefficients is equal to 0. Then, x minus 1 is a factor. You remember, children? Sum of coefficients in the given polynomial is equal to 0. Then, x minus 1 is a factor. If sum of coefficients of odd powers of variables, is equal to sum of coefficients of even powers of variables, then x plus 1 is a factor. In the previous problem, I discussed this. Now, we will apply this in this for this problem. So, since here x plus 1 is a factor, x plus 1 is a factor. That means what happens? Odd powers of variables must be equal to even powers of variables. Coefficients of odd powers and coefficients of even powers are equal. So, since x plus 1 is a factor, from this condition we can write odd powers means B, D. Even powers means A, C and E. So, from this we can write A plus C plus E is equal to B plus D. So, A plus C plus E is equal to B plus D. One condition is satisfied. Now, we have to prove this A plus C plus E is equal to B plus D is equal to 0. Here, one more factor is here. X minus 1 is a factor. If x minus 1 is a factor, then sum of coefficients of the variables is equal to 0. So, what are the coefficients here? A, B, C, D, E. So, from this condition, we can write A plus B plus C plus D plus E is equal to 0. This is second condition. From the first condition, instead of A plus C plus E, we can write B plus D because A plus C plus E is equal to B plus D. So, I am substituting this equation in the second equation. So, in place of A plus C plus E, I am writing B plus D. B plus D. And again we have one more B plus D is equal to 0. B plus D into B plus D. 2 into B plus D is equal to 0. That means B plus D is equal to 0. So, B plus D is equal to 0. From the first condition, B plus D is equal to A plus C plus E. Therefore, A plus C plus E is also equal to 0. Therefore, A plus C plus E is equal to B plus D is equal to 0. That's what we have to prove. Okay, children? B equal to... Okay, children, let's see one more problem. If x square minus x minus 6 and x square plus 3x minus 18 have a common factor x minus a, then find the value of a. How many polynomials given here, children? Two polynomials. And these two polynomials have a common factor. And that factor is x minus a. Then find the value of a. Let the given polynomial, first polynomial is p of x is equal to x square minus x minus 6. And the second polynomial is g of x is equal to x square plus 3x minus 18. And p of x has a factor x minus a. And g of x is also have a factor x minus a. Since x minus a is a factor, p of a is equal to 0 from factor theorem. And here also, since x minus a is a factor, g of a is equal to 0. Okay, children? Here, these two polynomials have common factor and p of a is equal to 0 and g of a is equal to 0. Therefore, definitely p of a must be equal to g of a. So, that means if we find p of a and g of a and we equal these two values, then we will get the value of a. Now, we will find first p of a. That means in the given polynomial p of x, instead of x, we have to write a. What is p of x? X square minus x minus 6. In place of x, we have to write a. So, that means p of a is equal to a square minus a minus 6. and now g of a. G of a is equal to, in place of the polynomial g of x, in place of x we have to write a. What is the g of x? X square plus 3x. 3x minus 18. In place of x we have to write a. That is equal to a square plus 3a minus 18. We have a condition P of A is equal to G of A. Therefore, here what is P of A? A square minus A minus 6. And what is G of A? A square plus 3A and minus 18. These two are equal. A square minus A minus 6 is equal to A square plus 3A minus 18. So you all know, children, how to solve these equations. Here a square and here a square with the same sign plus. Therefore these two are getting cancelled. What are remaining terms? Minus a minus 6 is equal to 3a minus 18. Now, we will write a terms together and this constants together. Minus a. If this 3a plus 3a transforms this side, it will be minus 3a. Minus 6 is equal to minus 18. Now again, minus a minus 3a is equal to minus 18. If minus 6 transforms that side, we will get it is plus 6. Minus a minus 3a means it is minus 4a. Minus 18 plus 6. That means it is how much, children? Minus 12. If minus 4a is equal to minus 12, what is a here? 4 is multiplying here. Minus 4 is multiplying here. Therefore, to get the value of a, we have to divide with minus 4. Minus minus getting cancelled. 4 1 ja 4 3 ja. So a is equal to 3. This is the value what we required. X square minus x minus 6 and x square plus 3x minus 18 have a common factor x minus a. Then the value is of a is 3. That means x minus 3 is the common factor for both the given polynomials. Okay. Okay, children, application of this factor theorem, you will get this type of problems in exercise 2.4. You can do all those problems, children. Now, we will take one more topic, factorization. Our chapter is polynomials and factorization. Now, factorization. What are factors and what is factorization? From numerals, if you take a number 18, how will you write the factors of 18? 1 into 18, 2 into 9, 2 9 ja 18, 3 6 ja 18. So, is it again need to write 6 3 ja, children? No need, because 3 6 ja 6 3 is the same. So, it is repeating means you can stop the writing the factors up to here. Now, what are the factors of 18? 1, 18. 2, 9, 3, 6. So, factors of 18 are 1, 2, 3, 6, 9, 8. 1, 2, 3, 6, 9 and 18 are the factors of 18. That means, a number can be written as product of two numbers. Then the two numbers are factors of the given number. Like that, for polynomials. So, that means, children, 18 is factorized as 1 into 18 or 2 into 9 or 3 into 6. Like this, we can factorize the polynomials also. For this, first we will take a quadratic polynomial. Do you remember, children, what are quadratic polynomials? A polynomial with degree 2 is called quadratic polynomial. Its general form is ax square plus bx plus c, and where a not equal to 0. This is the form of quadratic polynomial. This quadratic polynomial can be factorized with product of two linear polynomials. We will see one problem, how to factorize this quadratic polynomials. Factorize 2x square plus 3x plus 1. You know how to factorize this quadratic polynomials in your 8th class children. Once again we will recall here, 2x square plus 3x plus 1. So given polynomial p of x is equal to 2x square plus 3x plus 1. Now to factorize this polynomial, once we have to check what we have to do, the coefficient of x square term into constant term, 2 into 1 is equal to 2. Now if we write these two as factors, the sum or product of the two numbers must be plus 3. Sum or difference of the two numbers must be plus 3. Now 2 into 1 is 2 and 2 plus 1 is also 3. So from this we can write this 3x as 2x plus x. So that means 2x square plus 3x can be written as sum of two polynomials, 2x plus x, 1x means x plus 1. Now from these four terms we divide these two terms and these two terms. From these two terms 2 and x is common. So here we have 2x and here also we have 2x. That means 2x square can be written as 2 into x plus 2x means it is 2x. Again it is 1 into x plus 1. So 2 is common in these two terms and x is also common in these two terms. So I will write these 2x outside the bracket. If I write 2x here, I have the sign plus. And 2x I wrote outside the bracket. So what is the remaining term here? Nothing is there, means we have to write 1. Okay. Now again, from these two terms, 1 into x plus 1. That means we have to write 1 as a common. So if I write 1 here, what is the term remained here? X plus 1. From this, x plus 1 and x plus 1 in these two terms common. So first I write x plus 1 here. If I write x plus 1, what is the remaining term? 2x. From here x plus 1 is outside, so I have to write 1. So x plus 1 into 2x plus 1. That means given quadratic polynomial 2x square plus 3x plus 1 can be written as 2x square plus 3x plus 1 can be written as x plus 1 into 2x plus 1. So quadratic polynomial can be factorized with product of two linear polynomials. Okay children, we will do some more problems on this factorization. Okay children, one more quadratic polynomial, x square minus x minus 12. We have to factorize this. So first, what is the first step we have to take? What is the coefficient of x square term here? Coefficient of x square term is 1. So 1 into what is the constant here? 12. Along with the sign we have to take. 1 into minus 12 means it is minus 12. That means we have to write the factors for minus 12. If we subtract or add these two factors, we have to get minus, what is the coefficient of x term here? 1. So we have to get minus 1. So What are the factors of minus 12? 2 into 6 is equal to 12. To get the minus 12, we can multiply minus 2 into 6 or 2 into minus 6. Okay, children? Next. 3 fours are 12. To get minus 12, it may be minus 3 into 4 or 3 into minus 4. Okay. Now, so here 1 is plus and 1 is minus. 1 is negative and 1 is positive. So, if one term is positive, one term is negative, definitely we have to subtract those two terms. So, if I subtract these terms, what I have to get? Minus 1. So, minus 12 plus 1, I will get minus 11. So, this condition is not applicable. Minus 2 plus 6, I will get plus 4. So, this is also not applicable. 2 plus minus 6, minus 4, not applicable. Minus 3 plus 4, what is minus 3 plus 4? It is 1. But I need minus 1. Therefore, it is also not applicable. So, plus 3 minus 4. It is minus 1. So, we need only minus 1. Therefore, this condition. So, minus 1x can be written as plus 3x minus 4x. Okay, children? So, x square minus x minus 12 can be written as x square plus 3x and minus 4x minus 12. Now these two terms and these two terms. So x square plus 3x. X is common here. X square means there is 2x's. And in this term we have one more x. So x can be come out. So, what is the remaining term here? X. And I have plus. And if I write X outside, what is the remaining term? Plus 3. Now, these two terms. In these two terms, minus 4 into X minus and 12 can be written as 4 into 3. That means 4 is common in these two terms and also minus is also common. So, minus 4 is outside the bracket. If I write minus 4 here, what is the remaining term? X. And also, I write here also minus, I write the outside. So, what will be the sign here? Plus. Minus into plus, minus. And if I write 4, what is the remaining term? 3. So, x square plus 3x minus 4x minus 12 can be written as x into x plus 3 minus 4 into x plus 3. Now, x plus 3 and x plus 3 are common. X plus 3. So, if I write x plus 3, what is the remaining term? X. And this x plus 3 remaining term is minus 4. That is, the factors of x plus 3, factors of x square minus x minus 12 are x plus 3 and x minus 4. That means x square minus x minus 12 can be factorized as product of two linear polynomials, x plus 3 and x minus 4. Okay, children, next problem. 6x square plus 19x plus 15. How to factorize this? So, first, the coefficient of x square into constant, 6 into 15. It is 19. So, what we have to get? 19. So, it is a positive term. So, we can write. And 19 is also positive. So, 10, 9, 90, you all know, children. So, 10 plus 9, we get 19. Therefore, 19x can be written as 10x plus 9x. That implies 6x square plus 10x plus 9x plus 15. Now, how to get the terms common from this? 6 can be written as 2 into 3 and x square can be written as x into x. and 10 can be written as 2 into 5 into x, 10x plus 9x, 3 into 3 into x plus 15 can be written as 3 into 15. So from these two terms and from these two terms we have to write common terms. 2, 2, x, x. So if I write 2x outside, what are the remaining terms? 3x plus the remaining term is 5. From this, 3, 3 is common and both the signs are plus. So plus 3 is outside. Remaining terms 3x plus 5. So 3x plus 5 and 3x plus 5. That implies 3x plus 5 into 2x plus 3. So 6x square plus 6x square plus 19x plus 15 can be factorized as 3x plus 5 into 2x plus 3. Okay children, you have some do these problems in your textbook, and in 2.4 also you have this type of problems. You practice this quadratic polynomial how to factorize. Tomorrow we will continue with cubic polynomial. What we discussed in today's class children, factorizing factor theorem and factorizing of a polynomial. We will continue tomorrow children. Thank you one and all.